should prove to be a good one between the Arizona Cardinals and the Indianapolis Colts. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. On first down, Swift. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. It's a gain of 11 and a Cardinal first down.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
Right back to him on first down. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. 2nd and 3. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. 4 yards the pickup. First down.
And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
All right, that one fell incomplete there, but the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better that it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
This is 3rd and 1, very likely 4-down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Back to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 28.
Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on 3rd down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Well, he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
And they'll get 9 there as that sets them up better for 3rd down. And how about this first drive? They're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
The last catch nearly got them a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on 3rd and inches. Over the middle, complete. That's Robertson. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that could be pinpoint here.
As I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
Chances are good he's going to be a very busy guy. 2 catches already in this opening drive, and they were looking his way for a 3rd.
I think they put this defense on notice that could be a really, really frequent combination.
They'll go again here from the
the 10-yard line on second and goal. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Austin Carr keeping it himself from 10 yards away. And the Cardinals take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Extra point attempt here still to come. And the Cardinals will go up 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now Indianapolis set to take the field.
For them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
The last run got a couple here, second and eight. They're going to look to throw. For Marshall, that's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
That last catch, short of the marker by just a yard, leaves him with a very manageable second and one. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. Right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on third down. They'll look to throw here. He's going to sling this deep down. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. That's a gain of nearly 40 yards on third and medium to pick up the first.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. 6 yards there on the keeper. It's second down.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
This defense hasn't let him in yet. They'll need to stiffen here. 3rd and goal from the 2. They'll try to run this one in. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on 4th and goal. Frank Reich here on 4th down is ready to try for 3. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you 6?
The lead cut to just 4 as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. This is taken at his 4. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Cardinals getting ready to set up shop again here on offense. And they're still below 500. They were hoping to get to 500 with the Week 9 game against San Francisco, but fell a little short. Lost to 28-25 to drop to 3-5-1. But I'll tell you what, this team after a rough start to the season, Charles, is sort of coming into form.
I go back to the beginning of the season. I thought they weren't going to be very good at all. I thought 3 wins max for the season. They've exceeded that. Well, they're going to exceed that. And they are a tough out no matter who they are playing. They're getting better, not just on offense, where they spend a lot of their draft capital with Kyler Murray as their quarterback, but on defense as well. And they really took San Francisco to the limit and saved a little bit of mismanagement from the sideline in that game. They had a heck of a chance. So if you're playing Arizona now, you better bring your game with you because they're good enough to beat anyone.
One interesting note, they had beaten the Niners 8 straight times going into that matchup, but that record is now at 8-1 over the last 9 matchups. Now a deep ball there on 2nd down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8.
Watch the run.
kicker here. It's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They'll run on first down. Swift and able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They'll look to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. That was play number seven on this drive, and it got him 7 yards. This will be play number seven on the drive. Third and a yard. They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up fourth down.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. And no, it doesn't get there. Hits the crossbar, bounces back out. He had it online, but it comes up about a rotation short. Well, he had that one on target. That's half the battle. The other half of the battle, however, is distance.
And he nearly had that, too. But it was the crossbar that said otherwise. And that'll deny him a shot at three.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Looking for an opening. Not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Now back to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And the second wave of tacklers is gonna get him as they stop him behind the line. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. Second and 11. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll drop the throw. He's got a man open. That's Marshall. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. They chalk that one up as a gain of 34 on third down.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make the play on the football.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. the hookup. It's complete. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. You're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines.
Now he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. From 3 yards out, and the Colts have taken the lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is now 10-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time? Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
A loss of two there, second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
He'll look to throw, and he will find his man on the outside. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
The Cardinals on third down. They've been good, 3-for-4 thus far. This is third and 8. They'll set up to throw. And that will be incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Fielded at the 20. It'll wind up being a net of 41. 9-yard return, 50 on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments, and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
pass catch short of the marker by just a yard. Leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Now a handoff here to his running back. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. Give the Colts 13 yards and a first down.
Partney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go. Let's see who's faster.
We got four. And he'll give it here to his running back. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Second and nine now. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field, has popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
The Colts on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and nine. He'll drop to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Give him 3 on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked out inside the 5-yard line.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. On first down, Swift. And that won't buy him much room. Just a 1 yard gain to the 5.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. On second down, Swift. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of 2.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
The Cardinals on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. They'll set up a throw. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. That goes for 14 yards, first down Cardinals. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That goes for a gain of 31. Back in the first quarter, you said it, they need to avoid the big play, but he just got a big one right there.
You can't relax, you know. We talked about in the first quarter, but as the game progresses, still opportunities, and he took advantage of one there.
They'll run on first down. Swift, and past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Cardinals first down as well.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his 5th catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. 2nd and 5 after the 5-yard completion on 1st down. And they give this time to the tailback. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. To the left side, it's complete. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown as they have now chopped this lead down to 3. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go. Look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown. That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
2nd and 2. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A 2-yard touchdown grab, and the Cardinals have retaken the lead.
As a former defender, I would be angry as well. Could not get off the field. Well-executed offensive drive, no matter what the defense tried, they couldn't stop them.
Point after, right down the middle, and the lead is now 14-10. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, if it was to bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Here we go. He's up over 50 yards receiving now in this first half. It's a 1st down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Back to throw here. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Well, hey, we talked about the AFC playoff picture. Let's look at the NFC. That's a different story. You've got Dallas and Philly neck and neck in the East, then Green Bay, New Orleans, and San Francisco as division leaders. But with only two more wild card spots, there'll be some good teams left out in the cold in January.
Yeah, because right now you got Seattle at set.
And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. He's got a man. That's Marshall. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It'll be a gain of 17 and an Indianapolis first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. They'll look to throw here on first down. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with, but it's second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Now this throw caught left side, and he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. He'll look to throw. That's going to be caught. And he'll be out of bounds. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Got to love the catch. I think you got to love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great. And they're fun. They've become a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are. And I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing. But I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. Here we go on second and 12. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And now they're looking for 19 yards here on third down following two negative plays. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. Well, so a drive that spans all that time, and yet you may only come away with 3 points here.
But your defense, all right, they actually like these long drives. They get to rest over on the sidelines for a while. But when you're not finishing with points in terms of touchdowns, that's frustrating. They've got to figure out how to close out these long drives and get sixes instead of threes.
And his kick is indeed good. And the lead is down to one now at 14-13. So they get three, certainly hoping for six after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
So we're back to a one-point game now as the kickoff comes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up. And going to halftime, looking at each other, wondering what if.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Stepping aside from this game for a second, how about us being in week 10 of the NFL season right now? That makes me want to resurface that MVP talk we had earlier in the year. Who do you have right now leading in the MVP race?
Is this quarterback's edition only, or can we actually bring other people into it?
Yeah, go wherever.
Because the league does tell you that MVP can be anyone, but numbers show us it's really got to be a quarterback. So let's just start there, right? Russell Wilson in Seattle. I think he has to be a prime guy. I think you have to look at Tom Brady, all right? It's always Tom Brady. Patrick Mahomes, if he can get back into the lineup and be his usual self, he could get into this race again and maybe defend his crown. And Aaron Rodgers from Green Bay has really come on in recent weeks despite a stumble against the Chargers this past week. But how about Lamar Jackson? I mean, what he's doing with Baltimore and their win over New England, you've got to have him as a prime candidate. And you know how much I love Christian McCaffrey.
Yeah, he's a special one, isn't he?
Oh, he is absolutely special because he does it all. And if they weren't risking injury, he'd run back kicks, too.
Just a yard return there after a punt of 49. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Colts now, their offense works their way back onto the field. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. So due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter. The Cards with a lead, and they will get this football first as the second half gets started. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Here's a second and seven. Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. Looking to throw. The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack.
There's a little bit of defense right there. Nickel set, five defensive backs. They just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback never got rid of the football.
The Colts send out their punter as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away.
Whoosh.
Just a two-yard return there following a punt of 48. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. CD, we're already firmly in the month of November, so I want to go ahead and take a look at the AFC playoff picture. Right now, division leaders, New England, Baltimore, Houston, and KC. If it ended today, the wild cards would go to Buffalo and Indianapolis. And you think those are going to be the six? Probably some shuffling along the way.
There will be some shuffling along the way, maybe more in seeding than in actual teams, because when you look into who's in the wild card hunt right now, Pittsburgh, Oakland, both 4-4, Tennessee and Jacksonville at 4-5. The way teams are playing, they may just knock off each other. I think all the teams we listed have a heck of a chance of making it to the playoffs.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. Throwing right, and that's complete. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 27-yard line. From Colts territory, here's a 1st and 10 at the 27. Back to throw. And this is caught at the 8. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing. And as a player, that means an awful lot.
2nd and goal from inside the 5. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. Call it no gain that time, and now it's 3rd and goal.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They've been so good on 3rd down all day long. Can they convert another here on 3rd and goal? They're going to look to throw. His pass caught at the 4. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up 4th down. If you're going to pass down here, you better get that in the end zone.
I agree with you totally. And as we both know, the field's already condensed. There's just not a lot of space. So you've got to create some by getting some people downfield into the end zone. If you want to throw it short, you've got to have some movement, some room in order to do that. That one didn't work.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So he missed that field goal earlier, but he says not this time. Able to knock it through, give his guys 3.
I like his poise. I like his confidence, his belief in himself. Sometimes when you miss that first one, you'll see a lot of guys sag and they can't make the next one. Not in this case. Stepped right up like a pro.
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the Colts offense now as they make their way onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And here's a good way to kick off a drive complete over the middle. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And he'll be down at the 46. So they go from 146 to the other on a pickup of 8. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. They'll run it now out of the gun. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on 2nd and 2. It's now 3rd and 1.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They'll look to throw here. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Sullivan. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 34-yard line. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. That 2nd down play nets a -4.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on 2nd down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about 1 yard, if that. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down.
One hallmark of good defenses. It's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And this one is right through. And that'll bring him back within a point. He's got 9 points on field goals now. He's made 3 of them. That gets him a bit closer, but there's no question they need to start turning some of these 3s into 6s.
And for him, it's not his concern, right? He just goes out there when they call on him and goes ahead and puts points up on the board. But the offense has got to get together and figure out what's stalling their drives so they have to keep calling on him.
So we're back to a 1-point game now as the kickoff comes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him with contract time. But that offense, They're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Second and 10. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll look to throw. And he finds a man in the crossing route. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. On first down, Swift. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. On the ground, Swift. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. A good chance this is 4 down territory if they're unable to.
so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work, and that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
Here we go, set, 91.
Quarterback, don't get nervous now. Grant again.
They'll run on first down, Swift. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard.
70, Indy. Run.
Second and 3. His throw incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. Now back to throw. His throw caught right around the 6. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I'd love to sit down at some point in our offseason and talk to these defensive coordinators in the red zone. Tight end is obviously a big threat, yet these guys continue to make plays. Is there any other way to stop them?
Apparently not in the red zone. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Cardinals push further out in front.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Extra point right down the middle. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
A gain of 11 that time and a Colts first down. This quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Here's second and 8. For Marshall, that's complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. A 14-yard gain for Indianapolis and also move the sticks.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 38. He'll look to throw. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
They'll drop the throw. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. We are back now in Sacramento. It's the Colts, so they've got the football, but they've got work to do, trailing here as we begin the fourth quarter. The Colts on third down. They've converted 6 times and could use a 7th here. This is 3rd and 8. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to come up well short as they rally up to stop him at about the 16. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A 16-yard touchdown. As they now sit just a 2-point conversion away from tying this game up in the 4th quarter. Well, it was 4th down, so there was pressure to begin with, and then you make a one-handed catch like that. What a play.
Just when you thought your blood pressure couldn't get any higher after having called for it on 4th down, you see a one-handed catch being attempted. I'm sure it spiked at that point for all the guys on that side of the field. And instead, they get a chance to celebrate. What a tremendous catch, bringing it down for the touchdown.
joins us at Bank of America State. So the lead shaved to two now as the kickoff is away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Now a play fake here on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
A throw over the middle, taken in. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else.
He wasn't ready.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
They'll set up a throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Robertson. 7 yards on the quick slant and a first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
On first down, Swift. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Now think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock. And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. Over the middle, complete. That's Robertson. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 41-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Called a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three down to the 38. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
They'll set up to throw. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down. Well, the crowd doesn't like that. Was going to bring up fourth. Now it's first.
They don't like it at all, do they? It brings them back into it, but really not in a positive way. Now they're angry. That can jangle a team a little bit as well. Pass interference ruined that series of downs for them.
Back to throw now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that's going to lead to a third and 12.
Here we go. 8-3. Right. Ready?
Back to throw here. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. As his guys are in for six, and the Cardinals push further out in front. Point after try forthcoming. And that makes it a 9-point game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. Start the drive. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Sullivan. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage.
Hey, you got three.
Two.
He'll drop to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. A good pickup there. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Over the middle, complete. That's Sullivan. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Nice hit, boy.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Second and 2. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
They give it off here to the tight end. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. And they'll go on the ground. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
He'll look to throw. And this is complete. It's Marshall. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now.
Ready, ready! 15-1.
And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. A 2-yard touchdown grab as they have now chopped this lead down to 3. Yeah, he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is down to 2. So the lead shaved to 2 now as the kickoff is away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your 4-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. Remember, the 4-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario, get enough first downs and make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long. Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. Now the Colts going to burn the 2nd of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this 4th quarter. So the big play gets them across midfield now for 1st and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw, and his throw's going to be incomplete. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last four or five plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. He wants it all for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. In for the score. And the Cardinals push further out in front. Charles, there aren't really any slow receivers, but there's fast and then really fast. He's really fast, and he showed off the afterburners there.
And that he is, because when he took off, I was thinking there's no chance that he can actually reach him with that pass. Yet he did, and he's still sprinting. And just think about what that does for everyone else on his team, because his ability to stretch a field opens things up for the rest of the receivers on the team.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken about 7 yards deep, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And the Colts coming out now, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Looking to erase a two-score deficit here in the fourth quarter, going for some big plays.
Yeah, they certainly were. They just decided one shot, didn't they? Forget trying to move the ball downfield in small little increments. Let's go for the big one. But how about the defense playing situational football, looking at the scoreboard and realizing what can hurt us most? The deep shot. They played it well.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. A 14-yard gain for Indianapolis, and also moved the sticks.
Come on, set.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Looking to throw. Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. The offense just continues to reign supreme. Big plays, both sides, back and forth. Tough to keep track of.
It certainly is, and I'm over here just marveling at what I'm seeing. It's tough for you, though. You got to call all these big plays and have all this emotion each time they go at each other.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. They'll look to throw here. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Sullivan. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
They got to get it to the 21 here on third down.
Everyone, four down.
They're going to look to throw. And that is incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This a 43-yard attempt. And his kick here is good. And that'll move him back within six now. So the field goal means we're back to a one-score game. But with no timeouts left, I think this has to be an onside kick.
I like your analysis there, partner. I think you're right. You need the ball back. That's probably your only avenue.
So just over 90 seconds to play, and this would figure to be about as critical as it gets here. And the Cardinals hands team able to secure the football. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
They'll run on first down. Swift. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there. And now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Ready. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. They'll keep it on the ground. Swift trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
So it's a win here for the Arizona Cardinals. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and, hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at EASports.com. So long, everybody.